Hey there, plinkers and hunters. How you doing? Thanks for joining me again on this segment for the commander. I've been fiddling with it, and let me tell you, wow. It is a Cadillac of PCPs. I was back here shooting it with the full power that you have the adjustments on, right here, and all the way down to low mode. Now, when it's on the low position, you can almost see the pellet taking off, going, but it does not have distance. So I worked with it, second one, third one, fourth one. Number four, wow, cracked the punch. So my expectations are there with this. I mean, I can't, I'm like a little kid. I'm just giggly, just, okay. So, once again, let me tell you right now, I'm just basically that guy in the backyard having fun, trying to share what I got with me. For some of the guys who want to know something about it, I just speak the backyard language, man. I mean, I enjoy watching everybody that have all that shows you feet per second, foot per impact. A lot of the guys, they're hardcore, and you learn. So, for me, I'm just going to let you know, wow, that sounded awesome. Wow, that was fast. Oh, I could see the trajectory leaving a little bit, but, you know, the most electronics I have with me is my rangefinder. And the rangefinder's pretty good. You know, it's pretty accurate of knowing how far your targets are going to be. That's one thing I liked. So, I've been having, like, rabbits and stuff in the distance. Set the scope. So we're here today to check out the range and the groupings of the commander. Right now I have a target, splatter target, 25 yards out. I'm gonna give it some shots there. But prior to that, we're gonna change this, which is so easy, to the suppressor. So I don't put it away with the suppressor on, but they made this so easy for anybody to change that you want to use your suppressor. Now, don't get me wrong, the Brocock's quiet already. But this makes it so much quieter. I mean, basically, you just hear the targets hitting harder than anything. And it just looks and sounds cool. Come on, let's admit it. First thing everybody thinks of is James Bond type guns. Now, these are really easy to put on for anybody, like, oh, you know, if I get them, like a cross thread or anything. No, it basically self-guides itself really, really well. In case anybody's wondering, yes, it is a Donnie FL. I think the Sumu. Once again, it is the 25 caliber. And just in case you're wondering, what will we be using today? H&N Field Target Trophies 25 cal. They are 20.6 grains. Okay. Hey, let me tell you guys, if you're just plinking and having fun and you're just getting into it, whenever you're around Big Five or you get a chance, eBay, Amazon, wherever you go, pick up a can, put it aside, because you don't realize how much you just keep plinking, or you just, button, you turn around, you look for your good pellets, they're gone. So I got my little stack growing up here, and like to show you a little bit later, a little footage of these suckers right here. Now these are Hunter Supply cast bullets, 49 grain. Wow, they're. I'll show you in a few minutes what it looks like. Take a look. What happens when that hits an object that doesn't move? Bam! Look at that. That is that. That's the side it hit. It's basically around without the brass on it. So let's get to this 25 yard check and we'll go from there. Got 25 and then we'll go to 40 and we'll see how 50 sounds. All right, join me on this. Once again, this is my first upgrade of the Cadillac versions. Not like the 100% accurate inside that dime, but let's see how a novice like me, I would consider, can do with this. All right, let's check it out. Let's see how we do. It's very quiet around here, so I'm pretty sure this thing's gonna sound like hush. Those four shots I did it on high power. Let's drop that power down some. Two notches. Them out. Well, you see my first ones were definitely up here. That high power, I guess you have to really adjust it, or who knows, maybe I need some more adjustments on the scope. But man, that is a really good group, and I've never, well, maybe I'm on Vader a little bit like that, but give me a chance and get this more tuned in, it'll be awesome. So let's go to the 40 yards, see how the groupings look there. All right, that was our 30, or 25, I mean. Now we're gonna go for the 40, see how they handle. Once again, we're gonna start full off it. Something's definitely different there, if you ask me, guys and girls. Going to the second to the bottom. See how these react. Go check this one out. So once again, these were the high powered 1, 2, 3, 4, and then these were the lower 1, 2, 3, 4. I don't know what to say, guys. I mean, it's awesome grouping still for me. Still totally awesome grouping. And I know as I fiddle with it more, I will get this a lot more accurate. I'm just a novice, guys, and look how good I got this at 40 yards. So next, let's move it to the 50. Okay, now we're gonna do full power. I would call it setting number 4, I guess. I don't know. Well, we look at the 50 yards. These here, I know for sure, 1, 2, 3, were the first ones I shot on low power. I know this was a heavy, and I know this was the heavy. So I'm not sure one of my shots went in here again. I'll look at the video. I haven't seen it yet. But here it is with it on full max power, number 4, right here. Now, once again, I'm a novice plinker in the backyard. I hunt whatever's behind my house. But let me tell you, I'm stoked with what I'm seeing here. Just got to figure out how to work these heavies. Here's 2 of them right there, flaming over here. Thanks for watching this, guys. I don't know what else to show you or tell you about this, but what do you think? The suppressor, is it interfering with the trajectory of the distance? We gotta try that out without the suppressor next time. So before I ended this video, I wanted to do a little update. I'm gonna be going hunting to the mountains, and I wanted to take some lead-free pellets. So the Brocock, I decided to flinker with it a little bit more, and I put out in the 50 yards. And the 50 yards, I sighted it in with these. They are 19.191 grains. Now, I'm noticing the different size of grains, heaviness on these pellets is giving me a different shot every time with different ones. So I stuck with these, got them sighted in case you want to know what they look like. You know what they look like? They look like you're gonna go hunt a werewolf. It looks silver. So I put the target out in 50 yards. 50 yards, high power. This is what I got. Now, 50 yards still, high powered. Scoped up the scope a little tighter. I got them here. Decided I'd try a little bit more. Sent 4 more shots. I got 2 in there and 2 side by side here. 1, 2, 1, 2. I'm thinking that's looking awesome, boys and girls. That's 50 yards. And then my final 50 yard, I only did 1 more shot, and it was in I didn't really focus really quick. I mean, took a long time focusing it. I just shot, and that's where I got it. Novice here, boys and girls, novice. This Brocock is awesome. It is the Cadillac of air guns. Now over here, these were different grain sizes. I don't remember. They were heavier than the lead-free ones. So that proved to me there, that popped in my head, that when the pellet has a heavier grain or a lighter grain, you will be getting different accuracy. Whether we like it or not, I've noticed this. So this is where you really have to get into details of knowledge of what you're shooting for your scope. Anyway, guys, I had to share this. A lot 100% better than I just showed you in the video. Let's go, Brocock.